Hi, my name is Maddie, and I'm an instructor with Wordfence. Today, we'll be talking about live traffic and how you can use it to monitor traffic and events on your WordPress site in real time. Wordfence's live traffic logs your traffic at the server level, which means it includes data that JavaScript-based packages like Google Analytics do not show you. Today, we'll look at what you can do in live traffic and show you some tricks to use live traffic more efficiently. Let's first navigate over to the Wordfence Tools page. Here, you'll notice we're on the Live Traffic tab by default. The first thing to note is that the newest entries and traffic to the site will be shown at the top. On the far left, we see a type column which shows a colored dot or icon. From our key in the bottom left of the screen, we see that a green dot is a human hit, the gray dot is a bot hit, a yellow dot being a warning, and the red dot being a blocked hit. The next thing that is helpful to note while browsing live traffic is the Expand All Results option on the top right-hand side. If we enable this, we notice our live traffic results now show more information. This will give our support team necessary information in the event you need to reach out with questions about traffic on your site. Notice we can see the location of the user, the page they were visiting, as well as some more blocking information in the event the user was blocked by the Wordfence firewall. And also notice after expanding these entries, we can also see that for some of these results, we have the option to block IP, run who is, see recent traffic, or add the param to firewall allow list. These options are helpful if you're familiar with the traffic and want to take action, or if you want to research more about the traffic by getting more information about the IP or recent activity from the IP on your site. The block IP option will block the IP for the amount of time you have set in rate limiting how long an IP is blocked when it breaks a rule option, which you can see right here. If you'd like to learn more about rate limiting settings, we have a dedicated video in our description. This block will then be stored in the Wordfence firewall blocking area and show a manual block by administrator, which you can see right here. One thing to note is that the default blocking time set by that option is 5 minutes. If you prefer for IPs to be locked out for a longer period of time, you can adjust that option in the rate limiting area or block the IP permanently via the firewall blocking page that we're on right now. And what you would do is just click to select it and click the Make Permanent button. Keep in mind that we do not typically recommend blocking IPs permanently or for long periods of time, as IPs change frequently for users. However, if you notice that the IP is constantly hitting the site, you can make an exception there. The last option we see, Add the param to firewall allow list, is useful in the event you are trying a specific functionality on the site, maybe using another plugin that is getting blocked by Wordfence and we need to allow list this functionality. When this option is used, the entry will be added to Wordfence, Firewall, All Firewall Options, and the Allow Listed URLs area, and it will say Allow Listed via Live Traffic. Keep in mind, it is important to be sure you trust the plugin or service you're using that was blocked before allow listing the action. If you'd like to learn more about allow listing plugins that may be getting blocked on your site, we have a dedicated video in our description. Now that you're familiar with how to navigate and take action on entries in live traffic, let's take a look at some of the live traffic options. From the live traffic page, we can expand the live traffic options tab where you can toggle more settings. We recommend logging only security-related traffic, which includes successful logins, login attempts, and various types of blocked requests, whereas the all traffic mode will log all traffic requests. You can configure a few settings here, such as amount of live traffic data to store. By default, the storage settings store up to 2,000 records for a maximum period of 30 days. Depending on the amount of traffic your site gets, you may only see a few days of traffic logged. If you want to be able to browse more traffic, you'll need to increase this number of rows and see what works best for your site based on the number of days you want to be able to see in live traffic. The last thing we'll take a look at are some more advanced features in live traffic. From the live traffic page, let's click the Show Advanced Filters option. We notice a new filter button appears when this option is enabled. If we click Filter, we see we have a number of options to search our live traffic entries. Let's click IP, and we notice a couple more fields appear. We'll leave the middle one set to equals, as we want to search for a specific IP. Next, we can input an IP to search live traffic for and then press the enter button when we're ready to search. This now shows only traffic to our site from that IP address and allows us to see what the user or bot was trying to access and take action. This is a good way to search for a specific entry if we have a lot of frequent traffic and need to find something fast to either allow list it, block it, or just observe the activity. That's how you navigate live traffic on your site. If you have any questions, please leave us a comment below. Thanks for watching, and we look forward to securing your WordPress website.